Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the laws of the brachas that you make on fragrances according to the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. And today are the final two halachas in this chapter. Reach she'en lo ikar. When you have a smell, a fragrance, that's not considered to be the main part of that fragrance, as he's going to explain. Kagoin, for example, begodim shem mugmarim shayu besamim munachem bichli v'kolat reyach. If you have clothing, in which we spoke about before, that there was incense that you lit in order to make the clothing smell good. I guess maybe in our day and age we would call it the detergent or the softeners that you add in there that has a fresh scent, and it's inside the clothing. Or you have the spices, you have fragrances that were inside of a clear vessel, and the vessel now has retained the fragrance of the incense that was in there, but the incense has been removed. So the main thing that makes the fragrance is no longer there. It's rather just in the clear in the vessel itself. So too of a person, he handles esrogim, and esrog we know is has a strong citrus smell to it, or b'shar peres hamirichim, or any other fruits that gives off a fragrance, and a person could smell that. V'nisha b'yodai or b'bigdol reyach, and the fragrance remains on your hands after you finish handling the esrog. You can smell your hands and you'll smell, it smells like an esrog, or it'll be on your clothes, whatever the case was where you had fruits that have a good smell to it and it ended up leaving its odor onto your clothing as well. Says the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, Ein mevarchen alav, you do not make a bracha on that smell. If you would smell your hands, if you would smell your clothing, if you would smell the vessel that once had the incense that's in there, but now it's no longer there, that's not called the ikar, that's not the main thing which is making the fragrance, and therefore there's nothing to make a bracha on. The remnants of a smell, of a fragrance, is not what Chazal, the sages, had in mind to make the bracha on. That's one halacha. And the last one is, B'simin kufnun beis, later we'll see in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, Yevar de asol arech b'besam shal isha. Over there we're going to see that it's prohibited for a man to smell the perfume that is on a woman, because it will lead a person to hear her, to have most likely improper thoughts when he smells the wonderful fragrance that is on a woman. And even if that's talking about a woman that's not his wife, and if it is his wife, when she's in the state of nida, of her monthly impurity from the menstrual cycle, also over there he's not allowed to smell perfume that would be on his wife, because it might lead to things that are inappropriate during her days of nida. And we'll also learn further, if there is some type of avodah zarah, idol worship, and they light incense for the sake of worshiping that idol, or for one of their seances, or one of their events, or their baptizing, whatever it might be, so it's also, you're not allowed, it's prohibited to smell the fragrance that was made specifically for this type of avodah zarah, this type of idol worship ceremony which is taking place. So if these things are also, you're not allowed to smell them, then certainly you're not allowed to make a bracha on them either. Which means that if you would purposely go and smell the perfume that is on a woman who either is not your wife, or she is your wife, but it's the time of her menstrual cycle, you're not allowed to do that. And if you do it, you do not make a bracha, because you're making a blessing on something that is asur, that is prohibited. If there was avodah zarah, there was idol worship, and the idol worshippers lit incense or some other fragrant type of property there that made a good, pleasing smell, it's also you're not allowed to smell it. And therefore, if you did, you would not make a bracha, because that's not appropriate. That's the end of the halachas of the 58th chapter over here in Kitzur Shulchan Aruch. And Be'ez HaShem, we shall continue tomorrow with the laws of the blessings of Shechiyanu and Atoy V'Ameitiv. Looking forward to continuing our learning tomorrow. All the best.